When I was a child, my brother would tell me a bedtime story about the man who murdered our father, who stabbed him in the back and cut his throat.
Glad to see you're protecting the throne.
Who sat down on the Iron Throne and watched as his blood poured onto the floor.
That's where that Stark found me.
He told me other stories as well, about all the things we would do to that man.
This monster killed my son.
And crippled mine. He will answer for his crimes, I promise you. But not here.
He attacked my father in the streets. He tried to destroy my house and my family, the same as he did yours.
We were at war. Everything I did for my house and my family. I'd do it all again.
The things we do for love.
He is a man of honor. But when we were both taken prisoner and the men holding us tried to force themselves on me, Sir Jaime defended me.
Get behind me.
And lost his hand because of it. Without him, my lady, you would not be alive. He armed me, armored me, and sent me to find you and bring you home. Because he'd sworn an oath to your mother.
You're a knight, Sir Jaime.
I know there is honor in you. I've seen it myself.
I'm a Lannister.
You're a Lannister. You think your bloody honor comes before
my
your
bloody honor is beyond repair.
It's a good thing I am who I am. But I've been useless at anything else.
It's the family name that lives on. It's all that lives on. Not your personal glory, not your honor, but family.
Do you understand?
When you hear them whispering Kingslayer behind your back, doesn't it bother you?
Of course it bothers me.
Here we are now. Two Kingslayers.
A lion doesn't concern himself with the opinions of a sheep. I need you to become the man you were always meant to be. Not next year.
Hurry, you idiot.
Not tomorrow.
No. I want right. Does the wolf catch the lion?
Come on, boy.
Come on.
Oathbreaker,
man without honor.
The Kingslayer!
Jaime. My name's Jaime.
When we met your sister, she promised she would show you to us. Every day we would ask, every day she would say, soon. Then she and your brother took us to your nursery and she unveiled Ifri.
You've always pitied him, our poor little brother.
If it weren't for you, I never would have survived my childhood.
You would have.
We didn't try to hide our disappointment. That's not a monster, I told Cersei. That's just a baby.
You were the only one.
Tyrion's my brother.
He didn't treat me like a monster.
And she said he killed my mother. And she pinched your little cock so hard I thought she might pull it off. Until your brother made her stop.
You were all I had.
Once you said, family is what lives on, all that lives on. Told me about a dynasty that would last 1,000 years.
You think I'm a good man?
All of us have to believe that we're decent. How do you tell yourself you're decent after everything that you've done?
I pushed a boy out of a tower window, crippled him for life. For Cersei, the boy.
if he does, I'll kill him. Him and stop the kingdom, not a lot of them, until you and I are the only people left in this world.
I'm the only one you have left. Our children are gone. Our father is gone. It's just me and you now.
She's hateful. And so am I.
Kingslayer!
You are going to the deepest of the seven hells if the gods are just.
What gods are those? The trees your husband prayed to? Where were the trees when his head was getting chopped off? If your gods are real, and if they're just, why is the world so full of injustice?
Because of men like you.
Nothing else matters. There are no men like me.
Nothing else matters.
Only me.
Only us.
So this is the famous Book of Brothers. It's Arthur Dayne. The Sword of the Morning.
Barrison Selmy, painter who only used red.
Sir Duncan the Tall. Four pages for Sir Duncan. He must have been quite a man.
So they say.
Sir Jamie Lannister. Hmm?